Welcome to Thurman Action at Gulfstream Park. I'm Katie Stazak. It's Friday, and what a beautiful day it is here in Hollandale Beach. We have an 11-race program on tap today with carryovers in both the Rainbow Six and the Super High Five. It's going to be a great day of betting. We've got some pretty competitive races on tap. So let's get right to things. Here are the track and weather conditions for today's program, even though I gave you a hint.
The main track is fast and the turf course is firm. The first race on Friday's program is a $16,000 claiming event. Fillies and mares, three-year-olds and up, which have not won two races, will be going a mile on the turf course. No scratches or jockey changes to report in the opener.
Throughout the post. Racing at Gulfstream. From the outside, Patient Digna will try to secure the early lead. Moving with her in the early stages is Rose Festival. A Vivacious Annie is away racing in third. Toward the rail, that's Polly My Love, and wide on the course, Bellina Lady. Followed inside by Samarkanda there with Diana's Daisy alongside. Miss Kip Mambo is a bit wide through that first turn, and Starship Sassy tucks in. They run around the first turn, and Patient Digna opens a two-length lead for Juan Leyva from Rose Festival second. Vivacious Annie third, Polly My Love on hold while fourth. Diana's Daisy is there fifth, Bellina Lady now sixth. Samarkanda is four wide and marching forward for Castillo in front of Miss Kit Mambo and Starship Sassy. The leader has them stacked and packed here. Patient Digna by a length and a quarter. Big rush on the outside from Samarkanda to quicken the cadence. And going in the between horses is Rose Festival. Vivacious Annie tried to quicken with them but had to shuffle back to fourth. Then to the outside it's Bellina Lady followed by Diana's Daisy and Miss Kit Mambo. Polly My Love is now second last and Starship Sassy continues at the back. They went 25-1 for the quarter time and they went a half mile in 50 seconds flat. Patient Digna on the board at 6-1 and still in front. Toward the outside, Samarkanda is now second. Starship Sassy is running on well from the back. She was last, but she's tugging now while in traffic, only three lengths off the lead. Diana's Daisy trying to work out a trip, and Vivacious Annie along the inside. Bellina Lady is five wide, and this is completely up for grabs. Top of the lane, Patient Digna turns first on top. Vivacious Annie will get first crack at her, but over the top, Bellina Lady and Diana's Daisy both coming on. Inside the final furlong, here's Diana's Daisy from between them. Out wide, Bellina Lady driving to a short lead. Starship Sassy got out too late. Bellina Lady wins. Close then for second, either Diana's Daisy or Starship Sassy in 1:37.3.
Bellina Lady rallies to take the Friday opener. Edgar Zayas was awarded for trainer Antonio Machado and owners Mimai Trainer Services Corporation. Bellina Lady paid $5.60 to win. The second race is a $20,000 claimer. Fillies and mares, three-year-olds and up, which have not won two races, will be sprinting six furlongs on the main track. A field of six will go to the post.
They're off. Level beginning, Starship Tammy looks for the lead. Here's Trust Your Intuition moving up along the inside. Media Rule splits horses now and moves up to challenge for the lead. Away third is on the outside, Spectacular Flash, and along the inside, Spiritual Leader. They're followed by Starship Tammy, and Rosa Mystica does her best running later, and she's last of all as they run down the backstretch. Trust Your Intuition leads it three parts of a length, keeping her honest as Media Rule second. Stretch of three to Spectacular Flash third, now at the half-mile pole and about five lengths off the lead. She's three lengths better than Spiritual Leader and Starship Tammy, and the trailer is Rosa Mystica. Three furlongs left to go. Trust Your Intuition leads it by a neck. Up on the outside, Media Rules is now second. Here comes Spectacular Flash at the 5/16. Gaffleone has her in gear three wide, and she's moving up. Here's the bid from Spectacular Flash at the quarter pole to try to collar Trust Your Intuition. Trust Your Intuition is now collared by Spectacular Flash, who made a quick rush to the front. Back to second is Trust Your Intuition, three better than Media Rules, then Spiritual Leader inside the final furlong. Spectacular Flash working on a two-length lead. After a half mile and 46-2, the odds-on favorite to winner, Spectacular Flash, is moving away. Spectacular Flash, Gaffleone, and Nix win again. They're four in front. Trust Your Intuition second, Rosa Mystica from far back to be third in 1:12.2.
Spectacular Flash kicks clear to take the second race. Tyler Gaffleone was in the irons for trainer Ralph Nix and owners of Bridalwood Farm. Spectacular Flash paid $3.80 to win.
Charmin goes down the outside. Charmin goes chasing Danish Dynaformer. Danish Dynaformer. Charmin Ghost. And Charmin Ghost takes the Queen's Plate a length.
And taking the 156th running of the Queen's Plate is Charmin Ghost, beautifully bred by Ghost Zapper.
Classic Bloodlines, Classic Sire, Ghost Zapper, standing at Adena Springs.
Race number three is a $16,000 claimer. Fillies and mares 3 year olds and up, which have not won three races or which have not won a race since April 2nd of this year, will be sprinting 5 furlongs on the turf course.
And they're up. From the center, Wove gets the first call and will clear the field early. Wove is already two on top. Trio of Mischief is away in second. Morgan Falls off a step slow while third and moving forward. Little Daniela between horses. Stretch of two to Darn Proud, followed by You and Tequila, and the early trailer is another Smokey. They leave the backstretch and move on to the far turn. Wove has the lead by two. From between them, Little Daniela now races in second toward the outside. Morgan Falls third. Pocketed up fourth, Trio of Mischief. She'll have every opportunity from there. Two better than You and Tequila, then Darn Proud and another Smokey. That's the seven of them as they hit the top of the stretch. Wove confronted by Little Daniela. The rail's going to open for Trio of Mischief. She's had a dream setup if she can kick through. These three are 3 lengths better than Morgan Falls with an eighth of a mile to go. Trio of Mischief just took the lead, but Little Daniela continues to charge on the outside. These two to settle the score. Trio of Mischief for Little Daniela. Little Daniela's doing the better work, and Little Daniela will win it. Trio of Mischief, no excuse, second from Wove third, and Morgan Falls fourth. In 57 flat.
Little Daniela outruns Trio of Mischief to take the third race. Pedro Cotto Jr. was the winning rider for trainer Efren Loza Jr. and owner Anthony J. DePaula. Little Daniela returned $7.40 for her victory today. On to the fourth race now. This is a starter allowance. 3 year olds and up will be going 7 furlongs on the main track.
At the post. They're off. Slowly away from the gate there was Rancho, and also away awkwardly was Old Time's Sake. Double Judge has no problem clearing the field. He's 2.5 on top early from Union Label, who's away racing in second, starting to tighten the margin there. And from between horses, that's Cadillac Charm, who's now moving up to contest the issue as Double Judge is now chirped along by Alvarez to get some separation again. Cadillac Charm has lapped on him while second from Union Label, who's third. It's 3 lengths back to Russian Greek, fourth today, a half in front of Holy Highway, then Old Time's Sake, and the trailer is Rancho. They make their way past the half-mile pole. They went 23 seconds for the opening quarter speed. Double Judge is chirped along to still hold the lead. Cadillac Charm is second. Union Label is third. Holy Highway is now racing in fourth from fifth. It's the favorite Russian Greek. Then Old Time's Sake and Rancho. There's less than 3 furlongs to go. They went 46 seconds for an opening half mile. On top, it's now Cadillac Charm confronted by Union Label. Holy Highway has room inside. From the outside, Old Time's Sake is next, and they run to the top of the stretch. With the lead now, Union Label starts to move away. From the outside, Old Time's Sake tries to get after him second toward the rail and Holy Highway. 3/16 to go. On the outside, here's Old Time's Sake to take the lead now. Union Label is back to second toward the inside, Holy Highway, Cadillac Charm, and Russian Greek are next, but through deep stretch, it's Old Time's Sake and Rios moving clear. Old Time's Sake 3.5 in the end from Union Label second, Holy Highway third, and Russian Greek fourth in 1:23.3.
Old Time's Sake gets the win in his first start off the claim for trainer Manuel Morales. Jesus Rios was aboard for owners Alpha Stable Inc. Old Time's Sake, he wins his first race at the 7/8 mile distance today, and he paid $9.80 to do it. Let's get to the fifth race now. This is a $35,000 maiden claimer. 3 year olds and up will be sprinting 6 furlongs on the main track. Scratch the 6, honor earned.
They're off. From the center, Pure Talent gets the first call. Red Hot Ralph on the outside, and moving up on the inside is Key the Storm. Key the Storm takes the lead from Pure Talent, who settles down second. Equilibrium has now moved through to be third in front of Red Hot Ralph in fourth. It's a stretch of two to the team at the back, Indifferent, JB Quick, and Inspector Bill. They make their way down the backstretch and now move to the half-mile pole. Past the half-mile pole with Pure Talent engaging the pace setter, Key the Storm. From the outside, Red Hot Ralph is a joint third. Equilibrium rides the rail. It's a 2-length margin to Inspector Bill with JB Quick, and now the trailer is Indifferent. 3/8 of a mile away, Pure Talent gets away from Key the Storm. Up on the outside, Red Hot Ralph is into second. From the back, JB Quick and Inspector Bill work closer. Equilibrium had nothing to offer, and Indifferent is exactly that with a quarter of a mile left to go. On top here, it's Pure Talent and Edgar Zayas showing the way and widening the advantage. Red Hot Ralph just up and down second. JB Quick and Inspector Bill have a chance for that spot, but Pure Talent is fleeing the scene. Today's the day for Pure Talent. He's widening the advantage, and there's only a 16th to go. Zayas puts down the knee and runs out the clock. Pure Talent all alone. Pure Talent wrapped up in the end to win by 7. Red Hot Ralph will hold second. JB Quick third in front of Inspector Bill fourth in 1:11-2.
Pure Talent runs away from the field in the fifth race. He is much the best in breaking his maiden today for trainer Stanley Gold and owners Jack's Are Better Farm, Inc. Edgar Zayas gets another win on the card. Pure Talent paid $6 to win. The sixth race is a maiden special weight. Fillies and mares 3-year-olds and up will be going 7.5 furlongs on the turf course. Scratch the 5, the 10, and the 11.
Thorough. Tour of the rail, Wild Bill's Girl begins nicely. Here's the favorite, Bridal Fashion, moving to challenge. And from between horses, Killer Bird and Madu both away come away in the top flight. And up on the inside, Storm and Charlotte has now moved through to be fourth. In the run of the first turn, Wild Bill's Girl sets up shop on a two-length lead from Killer Bird, who races in second. Bridal Fashion a bit wide through the initial stages, racing a joint third. Down to the inside, that's Storm and Charlotte, followed by Madu. Stretch of another 2.5 to Ducasse with Gabby's Kitten along the inside and the early trailer, Rich Card Spun. They bend into the backstretch now. They head down the backstretch after a 22-4 opening quarter time, and here's Killer Bird to take on Wild Bill's Girl, a length and a half better than Bridled Fashion with Storm and Shard along the inside. 2.5 more to Madu, then Ducasse, second last now, and moving wide is Cardspun, and Gabby's Kitten is the trailer. She's fallen about 9 lengths off the lead. They make their way now to the far turn, and Storm and Charlotte has room inside as Wild Bill's Girl is a bit out in the center there, not cornering all that well. That's no good for Killer Bird, who sent even wider. Bridal Fashion slipped up the inside. Then Ducasse, followed by Madu and Cardspun, and Gabby's Kitten is not moving at the back. 46-3 for an opening half mile. They run to the top of the stretch. Storm and Charlotte 30-1 and on top, but Killer Bird under Zimmerman pressure, trying to get to the leader from second. From the back, here's Ducasse, while 4 wide, top of the lane. Killer Bird up for a short lead, trying to fight back Storm and Charlotte, and Ducasse is over the top. Ducasse at the leader, Killer Bird. Ducasse now in front. From between them, Bridled Fashion is into second, but Ducasse got the jump, and Ducasse and Edgar Zayas for a riding triple. He's 2.5 in front with Ducasse. Bridled Fashion second, Killer Bird third, Storm and Charlotte fourth.
Ducasse gets up to take the sixth race, breaking her maiden in her return to the turf course for trainer Marty Wolfson. Edgar Zayas notches his third riding victory of the day, the winning owner, Elizabeth Loftus. Ducasse paid $7.80 to win. She's a Florida bred.
There's a new day dawning in Florida. Never before has a Breeders' Cup Classic winner retired to stud in the Sunshine State. Until now. Adina Springs presents three-time Grade 1 winner and earner of over $4 million, Fort Larned. New to Adina Springs South.
Race number 7 is a $6,250 claimer. 3-year-olds and up will be going 6 furlongs on the main track. Scratch the 2, Bluegrass Derby. Also, Christopher McIntosh will be on the 3.
And they're up. Valdina Saint gets the first call after breaking sharply. Here's Caminito moving up to challenge for the lead. In between horses, Pecorino comes away in the top flight, and so too does DNA Approved. Back racing fifth along the inside is Great Victorian, 2 lengths better than the team at the back, Reggae Boy and Pro Fire. Down the backstretch they go, and Caminito has the lead 3/4 of a length. Pecorino moves to him while second at the half-mile pole. DNA Approved is now racing in third while 3 wide. Great Victorian along the inside fourth. A neck better than Valdina Saint, who's asked to quicken up, 2 lengths in front of Reggae Boy, and trailing the field is Profire. They run around the far turn. Now the pace quickens. Pecorino issues the challenge to Caminito, and these two throw it down now. They're open 6 on Valdina Saint, who just got around DNA Approved, and they're at the top of the stretch. edge. 23-second opening quarter, 46-1 for a half mile. Pecorino up and on the outside now takes the lead from Caminito, who's back to second. Eight lengths back to Valdina Saint third, and there's an eighth of a mile to go. And slowly but surely, it's Pecorino edging clear. Caminito's going to come off the fence to try to re-rally inside the 16th pole. Pecorino has the lead. Caminito can't reach him. Pecorino wins. Caminito second, Valdina Saint third, Profire fourth in 111-2.
Pecorino gets the win in the seventh race, giving jockey Harry Hernandez his first win back since returning from injury. Louis Duco was the winning trainer for owners Louis Duco Stables Inc. and Pristine Farms and Stud LLC. Pecorino paid $4.80 to win. On to the eighth race now, an $8,000 claimer. Fillies and mares, three-year-olds and up, which have not won three races, or three-year-olds, will be going a mile on the turf course. Scratch the 12 and the 13. Those are your main track-only participants.
They're off. Zamorano was off a step slow. Turf Fast wins the start and will try to get the lead, but Backyard Birdie has the same idea, and Backyard Birdie is quickest in the run to the first turn. Turf Fast will have to settle in second from Tormento de Oro, who's now racing on third. Now racing in fourth while saving ground is Principessa Gina. She's a length and a half clear of Greek Flower. Then it's Sartori Inn, situated about seven lengths off the lead. She's a length in front of Adar, who's racing about eight lengths off the lead now. It's a stretch of another length and a half to BT's Baby with Danube River and Zamorata, and five lengths detached. The trailer is Rachel's Girl. Into the backstretch, they drilled a quarter, 22-4. Stiff tempo being set by Longshot Backyard Birdie and Alex Gonzalez by two over Turf Fast, who tightens in while second, and Tormenta de Oro now pocketed up third. These top three have opened five on Principessa Gina, then Sartori Inn. Greek Flower is three wide. She's five lengths in front of Adar, who's racing all by herself about eight lengths off the lead now. Then it's three more to Zamorata with Danube River. BT's Baby has called it an afternoon, and Rachel's Girl is yet to be heard from. They run around the far turn and approach the top of the stretch. Hop on the outside, Turf Fast to confront Backyard Birdie. Sartori Inn and the green colors working out a trip on the far outside, and widest of all now coming on is Adar, held up in traffic. Greek Flower with Principessa Gina, and they're at the top of the stretch. Turf Fast just ran up to take the lead from Backyard Birdie, who's back to second. Adar down the center of the racetrack begins to motor from third. Then it's back to between horses to Tormenta de Oro. Final furlong, Turf Fast still has the lead. Up into second's Adar, but that's as far as she'll get. It's Turf Fast to win it. Very close for second here. Either Adar or Sartori Inn, and Tormenta de Oro fourth in 136 flat.
Turf Fast is your race eight winner. Jose Alvarez was aboard for trainer Aubrey Mirage and owners Rachel Jacobson and Dominic Auriccio. Turf Fast paid $7.40 to win today's eighth race. The ninth race is an allowance. Florida bred three-year-olds and up will be sprinting six furlongs on the main track. Eight will go to the post.
They're off. Poor beginning at the back for Big Awesome spotted the leader's three lengths. From the inside, of course, gets the first call. Donegal Hall showing speed, and up the rail, that's Chief Envoy. Moving into second now, splitting horses to start up. He's now racing in fourth. Then it's the favorite, J.S. Bach, racing fifth, about four lengths off the lead. Wide on the course is I Feel Great, then Valid Concept, and on the inside, Big Awesome. Past the half mile and moving to the far turn, it's, of course, on top by two now. Racing second is Chief Envoy from between horses, start up now third. Racing up on the outside and now fourth is the favorite J.S. Bach. It's a stretch of five to Big Awesome, in between horses Donegal Hall, then I Feel Great, and Valid Concept. There's 5/16 to go. J.S. Bach is now up to challenge for the lead. Start up right alongside. They've put, of course, away, and they're two better than Chief Envoy. Big Awesome rallies up the inside. They're at the top of the stretch. J.S. Bach now shaking up for the drive, trying to stay with them. Second is Start Up, three better than, of course, third. There's an eighth of a mile to go. J.S. Bach still has the lead. Start Up not going down without a fight, but J.S. Bach appears to just be too much horse in deep stretch. Donegal Hall putting in a charge for third, but the favorite's a winner. J.S. Bach, give Edgar Zayas four on the card. Start Up second in front of Donegal Hall third. Close fourth, either Chief Envoy or Big Awesome in 111-2.
J.S. Bach returns from an eight-month layoff to win the ninth race for trainer Todd Fletcher. Edgar Zayas notches his fourth victory of the day aboard this three-year-old colt. Donald R. Disney is the owner. J.S. Bach, welcome back to him. He paid $3.80 to win. The 10th race is an allowance. Three-year-olds and up will be going a mile on the main track. 10 will go to the post.
They're off. Aces for John begins nicely on the outside. Tiger of Wales is showing speed today. Down to the inside, Brown's Gap and Al Caravan marching forward. Along the inside, Tinto Mesa's in no hurry, just settling into stride mid-flight. Now emerging from between horses to take the lead, it's all over it. All over it leads out of the one-mile chute from All My Memories and King Ronto second and third. Racing fourth while four wide is Tiger of Wales. Then Tinto Mesa and Brown's Gap, followed by Al Caravan. Second last early in power, and the early trailer is the stretch runner Aces for John. Down the backstretch they go after completing an initial quarter of 24 seconds flat. Out there three wide, All My Memories and neck in front now. King Rontos alongside second, all over it now third. So him racing in fourth behind the speed is Tinto Mesa under Zayas. He's trying to find him some clear racetrack. Tiger of Wales keeps him pinned in for the moment. Two better than Brown's Gap. And Powers under a ride from Eddie Castro. Six lengths off the lead. Two and a half in front of Aces for John. And now Caravan is now the trailer. They run at the far turn, three furlongs left to go. On top, it's All My Memories. Tinto Mesa loaded, no place to go. Toward the outside, Tiger of Wales is coming on. Also circling horses on the outside. Here's Aces for John. Aces for John was last. He's now third, now second, and making a bid at Tiger of Wales, who just took the lead. From the back, Brown's Gap, and then Tinto Mesa, three quarters, 112 flat. Aces for John out in the center to try to get to the leader, Tiger of Wales. On the outside, and Brown's Gap's coming alive from third. Final furlong, Aces for John has the lead. Tiger of Wales is second. Brown's Gap on the outside. Back fourth in power, but Aces for John will go last to first to win by a half a length in the end. Tiger of Wales second. Brown's Gap third in front of in power fourth in 138 and four.
Aces for John gets up to take the 10th race. Jose Cruz is in the irons for trainer Alan Mirage and owner Raj Kamal Mirage. Aces for John paid $7.40 to win. The 11th and final race on Friday's program is a $10,000 maiden claimer. Three-year-olds and up will be going a mile on the main track. Scratch the 2 and the 5. That leaves us with 9.
And runners away. From the outside, Lighty Nighties De Roma showing first. Here's the favorite, El Kraken, on the offensive early on. Gunnery comes away with speed, and Gunnery will land in front, but El Kraken will keep him company, and Huddy Up drives it up along the inside. So as they leave the chute, it's Gunnery on the outside, El Kraken on the inside. A half a length better than a wide-running Leonides De Roma. Moving up now to be fourth is Black Phoenix from Huddy Up, who settles in fifth. He's a length better than Prince Runner alongside Batting Cage. Wide on the course, Magnus Maximus. And it's a stretch of another five lengths back. The early trailer here is Phil's Comprise. They went 23-3 for the opening quarter speed. And on the inside, El Kraken leads it a half a length. Gunnery is now second, a length and a half better than Black Phoenix, third, then Batting Cage, who's now in front of Leonides De Roma at the half-mile pole. They went 46-2 for a strong half-mile. Back racing on now, trying to get involved from the back is Huddy Up, spies an opening between horses, comes on to take third. Three lengths more to Prince Runner, then comes Phil's Comprise and Magnus Maximus. 5/16 away, the favorites are first and second. On top, El Kraken by a length and a half. Black Phoenix under a ride while trying to gain ground second. Five better than Leonides De Roma and Huddy Up. Then comes Prince Runner. They went three quarters in 112-1 in the wrap at the top of the stretch. And Zayas alive for five aboard El Kraken, but Black Phoenix issues the challenge on the outside. These two to square off at the final furlong with Black Phoenix now surging ahead. Back to second is El Kraken, seven better than Leonides De Roma, then Huddy Up. Racing in fifth to complete your high five is Batting Cage. To the finish, it's Black Phoenix in front. El Kraken second, Huddy Up third, Leonides De Roma fourth, and Batting Cage to complete your high five in 139-3.
Black Phoenix cruises in the 11th race. He breaks his maiden today for trainer Ramon Morales and owners Stronic Stables. Tyler Gaffleone notches a riding double on the day. Black Phoenix paid $7.80 to win. And here's how our exotic wagers paid today. The pick 4, 4 of 4, returned $116.85. The pick 5, 4 of 5, $6.25. 5 of 5, $276.30. The Rainbow 6, 6 of 6, $320.28. There will be a carryover heading into Saturday, and there will be a mandatory payout in the Rainbow 6, the pick 5, and the Super High 5. carryover heading into Saturday's program is $11,327.52.
That's going to do it for Friday's program. Believe it or not, tomorrow, Saturday, is closing day for the summer race meet here at Gulfstream. We have a special 12-race program that begins at 12:45 p.m. It is the Florida Sire Stakes finale. Six stakes races on our card worth $1.45 million. The day will be highlighted by the $500,000 In Reality and My Dear Girl divisions of the Florida Sire Stakes for colts and geldings and fillies, respectively. These freshman runners are going to be trying a mile and a 16th for the first time, so it's going to be anybody's game. We could see some surprises as these two-year-olds stretch out and some of them find their best strides going long. Of course, Ballet Diva and Tribal Drama are going to look to win two of the three legs of the Florida Sire Stakes, but the closers that were coming on well last time in Silent Prayer in Abercorn, they're going to be back at it, and they're going to be loving this extra distance. It's going to be a fun day. Don't miss any of the action. I'll see you right back here tomorrow. Thanks for watching Thoroughbred Action. For all of us here at Gulfstream, I'm Katie Stazak.